Hello there, and thank you very much for joining us in this new Azure Portal how-to video. Today, we learn how to use the Azure Portal homepage, and we have Sean Watson for that, who's going to teach us all about that. So thank you very much for joining us, Sean.
Thanks for having me, Leon. Yeah, so the Azure Portal homepage. We've made some updates in the coming weeks, and we're just going to talk through that and really give you some tips and tricks on how to make best use of them. So when you first land on home, you'll see that we have these multiple sections. We have the Azure Services, the Recents, Navigate Tools, and then you have the Useful Links and our beloved mobile app. One of the big things here, we've tried to really differentiate the two pieces. So we have Azure Services and Recent Resources. That's more about you and your usage of the product. And then we have a section which is going to be more fixed and something you can really rely on muscle memory to make use of. So let's dive into the Azure Services. From Azure Services, I can always get access to the marketplace via Create a Resource. So I can get the full suite of offering of all the different possible creates that we have. I have up to 8 of my most recently visited services. Now, if you're new to the product, these will be a featured set, but as you use the product, this will adapt over time to be the things that you've most used. And then finally, I have more services. So more services is really where I can get access to everything. And that is everything. So from these 8 here, they're my most recently used, but then at any point in time, I can really dive into the more services, which is the all services offering to you have today. And then you really see the full suite of things.
Perfect. So the more I use the product, this adjusts to my usage, but I can still go through the full offering and find anything else.
Yeah, exactly. So as you do use the product, this will adapt to you. But at any point in time, you can come to more services and get access to everything.
That sounds great.
Yeah. So recent resources. This section may or may not be there depending on your usage. But as you use the product, this will populate. And we have a limit of 12 recents we show here. But you can see here, I've got a section of recents which I've accessed over the last few minutes, but also over the last few days. And now we'll track that over many months too. So here I can see that I've got virtual machines and I've got app services which I've been manipulating and some of my specs that I've been writing recently. This is going to give you a one-click access to the recent resources that you navigate to very frequently. Now at any point in time, load up home, my recent resources are one click away and I can get straight into what I'm doing.
So that will give you like highest productivity, right? You guys just get there. If you need to stop that VM or start that VM or whatever, you go to home, one click away, it's right there.
And done. Yep, exactly that. Moving on to Navigate. So Navigate is this fixed section which we've curated based on where people like to actually spend their time from a sort of a repeated use. So subscriptions, resource groups, all resources, and my dashboards. I can always get access to these things. These things that used to be in the left navigation, and I've sort of had one click away. We've made sure they're one click away here too. Tools, the tools section itself, this is something which is cross-cutting. You can get access to Learn, where you get a whole suite of free resources from Microsoft, be it learning documentation and tutorials and different sort of step-through guides. Azure Monitor, where I can go through and monitor all my resources, set alerts, and great stuff like that. Security Center, where I can actually see all of my resources and which resources are in compliance and which are out, and really take action there and then to make sure I'm secure. And then cost management, so I can go through and create budgets, manipulate my costs, and really manage them and keep them under control.
Oh, that's great. And one of the things to mention, in addition of Learn being free and being awesome, is that we are adding Learn integration throughout the portal in many other places, right?
Yep.
And that, the idea is that as you're trying to use Azure and learn how to use Azure, we put the right content in front of you so you can use it effectively and learn it effectively.
Exactly. We want to make sure that bridge is created as best as we can. And then useful links, speaking of documentation, there's technical documentation links here, but you can also get links to an expert or be it, I want to go and get started quickly, there's reference to our Quick Start Center. And there's always a place to go and find the recent updates like we're talking about now. And then we have our mobile app. We have the mobile app for iOS and for Android. You can actually get access to the stores directly from the home page and go and download the apps.
Yeah, and let us know what you think. Also, it's an awesome app, right?
Exactly, yeah. Okay, yeah, so one of the things you may have noticed when you land on home is that the left navigation is no longer there. We've moved the left navigation to keep the product cleaner and allow you more focus when you're actually in the different experiences and navigate from page to page. So at any point in time, if I want to get back to my left navigation, I can come to the top left and click the hamburger, and I'll see that familiar left navigation, and I can dive off into my favorites and the sort of common set of navigate options we were talking about earlier. If pinning this thing is something you desire, you can come back to the settings page and you can go and change that setting and you can go back between the docked mode and the flyout mode at any point in time. If you're jumping between large and small resolutions, that's something you can quickly get access to. And then one last piece, you were talking about learning integration. So I just want to show you the service cards. There'll be a follow-up video on the depth of service cards and the offering that we have here, but I want to briefly touch upon it. So from home, you can actually hover on any of those recent services, and I can get quick access to recent resources within those services, create and browse, but also some of the free training and other useful links.
That's really great, and that's contextual, right? So
exactly.
Every service will get their own training.
Yep, and that's part of creating that bridge and creating a better link between the product and documentation.
That's really great. Thank you very much, Sean.
Oh, thank you.
And thanks every one of you for watching. Please leave us a comment on the video. Try all of these and let us know what you think. Follow us on Twitter. Thanks for watching and look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thanks.